winter and summer recreation area lying atop the Boise Ridge, just 10 miles as the crow flies from Idaho's capital city. Down and across its sun-bathed and snow-covered slopes in the wintertime swish thousands of native Idahoan tourist skiers participating in one of America's most rapid-growing sports. The future of the Bogus Basin Recreation Area as a community-sponsored facility to provide part to the good Western life to Boise Valley residents is assured by the young people who learn to love winter sports. Many of these children who now attend the Bogus Basin-operated ski school are youngsters of people who helped clear the first ski slopes at Bogus in the early 1940s. Their parents, amazed at the development of skiing and the basin in recent years, still ski at the site they helped to build. The growth of facilities has been matched by expansion of the population area which Bogus serves. The slopes now are filled regularly by residents of at least six counties, and there are always visitors from far distant points. The one feature of the Bogus Basin Recreation Area which hasn't changed much since the first days of skiing is the road between Bogus and Boise. The 18-mile route was built as a joint venture by federal, state, and county governments in the 1930s, but none of the cooperating agencies has taken over maintenance or improvements, and the road remains summer dust and winter mud, despite the tremendous increase in travel over it. Development of Bogus Basin itself as a community-operated facility has proceeded at a fantastic rate. The Bogus Basin Recreation Association, a coordinating body composed of representatives of service clubs, state agencies, the Forest Service, and other groups, was organized in the late 1940s. It took over operation of the Bogus Basin facilities from the private operator in 1952, inheriting a T-bar lift, two rope tows, and a CCC barracks building, which served as a cafeteria and warming hut. The T-bar could handle only 200 persons per hour. By 1956, the facilities were so overtaxed by the growing popularity of activities in Bogus Basin that impatient skiers had to wait in line as long as a half hour to get on the lift. The association recognized that expansion was needed, and needed badly. Members turned to the people of the community, the people who in fact own and operate the Bogus Basin Recreation Area, and the people of Boise responded by supplying $50,000 of interest-free bonds for the purchase and installation of two long Poma lifts, facilities noted for their high capacity and relatively low cost. The new lifts brought opening of new ski runs, spreading the crowds of skiers over more of the basin, bringing better and safer skiing. The 1958-59 ski season, although off to a late start at Bogus and elsewhere in the Northwest because of a lack of early snow, showed that the growth of skiing again had surpassed the growth of facilities in the basin, and expansion was needed once more. Directors of the association decided the time had come for installation of a double chairlift, a top-notch facility to best serve the people of the community and help Bogus Basin compete for the tourist skier business in Idaho. Two local businessmen purchased bonds to cover about half the cost of the chairlift. The balance of the fund is coming from other businessmen, service clubs, and individuals, and the chairlift was installed for the 1959-60 season. Bogus Basin will cater to all who love winter sports with facilities for the beginning child. The workhorse Poma lifts, which have spread skiing activity across the basin. The temperamental but still useful original T-bar. And the new chairlifts, which open still new vistas of activity on some of the best skiing slopes in the world. In three short years, the lift capacity has been increased from 200 skiers per hour to 2,200 per hour, a record of prideful progress for the Boise Valley and the people who have supported development of a great natural recreational resource. These people have put their money into Bogus Basin, and they support and use the area. Ski racing, a marvelous competitive sport for youngsters of all ages and sizes, is a feature of Bogus Basin. Each year, the area plays host for the Cranston Cup races, the Muddy Numbers Memorial Race, the Boise Junior College Invitational Races, and various Mighty Might events. In some years, the Pacific Northwest Giant Slalom Championships have been held at Bogus, and more top competitive events will be held there in the future. These events draw young skiers and their parents and advisors from throughout the Pacific Northwest. These visitors return to their homes with wonderful impressions of the skiing which Bogus Basin offers. And with terrible impressions of the bouncing and banging 17 miles which must be traveled on the Bogus Basin Road to get to that good skiing. The Idaho Department of Commerce and Development lists tourism in the state as a $110 million annual industry, the third largest factor in Idaho's economy. The license plates on autos in the Bogus Basin parking lot on a typical skiing day indicate that the area is an important part of that tourist industry, a part which could be still more important if it's served by an important road. Our out-of-state visitors expect and should have good access to the features which make tourism the asset it is to the state of Idaho. A count of skiers in the Bogus Basin area in 1958-59 indicated that probably 20,000 persons bounced their way from Boise to Bogus Basin over the inadequate road. On February 7, 1959, 493 automobiles went up the hill. The following day, the automobile count reached 757. Automobiles which carried winter sports participants all the way to the Bogus Basin parking lot paid a daily fee of 75 cents to help cover the cost of snow removal and road maintenance by the Bogus Basin Recreation Association. This toll, or tax, was in addition to the gasoline tax, which each and every driver pays for the right to have decent roads to serve his travel needs. The Bogus Basin Road is a heavily traveled road all year. It serves not only skiers, but also a large number of summer campers, hunters, firefighters, and the private and public television and radio facilities on Deer Point and Schaefer Butte. The hundreds of people who use the road each day are entitled to something better for the gasoline taxes they pay on the miles they clock over the Bogus Basin Road. Bogus Basin needs to be served by an improved all-weather road. A road surfaced with a Class C oil mat. The traffic which it bears demands and justifies that such a road be built.